Hi, everyone, and welcome to our webinar today entitled How AI-Powered Communications Will Enhance the Customer Experience in Insurance. I'm Liz Steffen, the VP of Customer Engagement at Striata, and I'll be your host. Let me give you some background on Striata. We are a digital communications company. We work with enterprises to help them create digital relationships with their end customers by increasing digital adoption and delivering the right message in the right channel at the right time. I personally have the pleasure of working with clients to help them do exactly this. I'm excited to be joined by Mia Papanikolaou, the COO for Striata in the Americas. Mia has been in the digital communication space for more than 18 years now, and has worked with many insurers providing strategy. She joins us to give her perspective on AI in insurance communications. Thanks, Mia, for joining us.
Thank you so much. I'm really excited to talk about the topic.
Awesome, we are too. So before we get started, let's just go over a few administrative tips. First, we want to hear from you, so we welcome questions during the webinar. You can post these in the questions section on your navigation bar. They'll be addressed at the end. There will also be a very short survey once the webinar concludes, so please take just a couple of minutes to assist us in providing us some feedback on the webinar. We want to make sure that future webinars have the content you need and find valuable. We've also included some additional resources as attachments. You can see them in the navigation pane, but don't worry, you'll also receive an email with the recording and a link to all of the additional resources in a day or so. Now, please feel free to post and tweet throughout the webinar using the hashtag you see on the screen, AI Communication. So with that, let's look at our agenda for today. We have quite a thought-provoking one. We'll begin with how the current insurance landscape is changing as it relates to customers and their expectations, and how artificial intelligence is playing a role in all of that now. Next, we'll discuss how insurers can use AI to enhance their customer communication and deliver a great customer experience. Then, we'll discuss with Mia specifics on how you can use AI to enhance the customer experience and what the benefits of doing so are for both the insured and the carrier. And then we'll wrap it all up with some key steps to implementing AI-driven communications. So to set the scene, let's take a look at the changing landscape. We live in a digital world. And as a result, your customer expectations are increasing based on the interactions that they're having with all the other brands in the world. At a recent insurance industry conference, these were discussed, and we've listed them out for you here. And if you look at the first one, this concept of instant information, we all have lots of apps on our phones, right? And these apps provide us with real-time data, allowing us to know exactly when our Uber driver is going to arrive, right? Where our pizza is in the pizza making process and in the delivery route, or even where our prescription is and when it's being worked on by the pharmacist and when it'll be ready for us to pick it up. It's an age of instant everything. And we know that instant everything needs to be the same across all channels, right? So this concept of ubiquity across channels, we see that happening where we can consume things in the physical world and that same experience is being presented to us in the digital world. That customer experience remains consistent throughout. And we know brands like Starbucks, they're doing a really great job of that. We know number three is no surprise, right? We've been talking about personalization for years, but brands in the retail sector especially have really taken it a step further and supplied customers with hyper-personalized experiences that are unique to the individual customer and not just the segment they belong to. And that's really what we're seeing is differentiating a good customer experience from an excellent one. And then let's think about human nature. Who doesn't love to maintain control over the buying process? We have apps now like Hilton where we can check in, we can choose the room. We can decide if we want to use an electronic key. We have complete control over the entire hotel check-in process, and we never have to speak to someone if we don't want to. And then finally, we have this concept of information for decision support. I think every single one of us on this webinar at some point has used Yelp, where we put in some information that populates a lot of data back to us, and then we use that information to make a decision. And we see that this is moving beyond the hospitality industries, and we're seeing a lot of use cases in healthcare. So given that your customers, as a carrier, they're having all of these wonderful experiences in the world around them, it's really important that you make strides in providing a better customer experience for them as well. It's no longer enough to focus on operational efficiencies only. And we know that when it comes to technology adoption, you know, historically carriers tend to sort of watch and learn to see what their peers do. Meanwhile, other industries are farther along in their digital transformation journeys. And as you can see from the study here on the screen by McKinsey, you know, the insurance sector is behind retail and technology, but ahead of the global average. So you have to ask yourself, especially in a market where there are so many insure techs that are bringing a new wave of competition to the fore, how can you as a carrier compete? Well, the answer lies within looking at digital maturity, not just from the technology perspective, but rather from the customer's perspective. So in doing so, you may have to spend a little bit more, right, than some other industries to catch up. The reality is, we know traditional carriers have structured their processes for trends from years ago. And as a result of that, a lot of your technology is composed of disparate, siloed systems that have a wealth of data, but don't necessarily speak to each other. That technology has therefore created dependencies within the enterprise, and those dependencies have made it difficult for carriers to feel like you can truly digitally transform. But an easy way to make it seem like you have transformed is by changing what the customer sees, or delivering a better experience to them through communications. By having so much data on hand, investing in AI technologies can allow you to transform the customer experience, particularly in customer communications, by bridging the gaps within the silos across different lines of business. I was listening to a really good webinar last week that was also on this topic of artificial intelligence and insurance. And the head of data science for AXA referred to this concept of using AI to create connected silos. And that's exactly the key, right? You don't need to change all of your technology. We need to look for tools, some AI tools that will allow you to create rich, hyper-personalized experiences with the data that you already have and the systems that you already have in place. So according to the graph on the screen, we know that AI is in the high range for technology investment over the next 3 years. But for you as a carrier, what's more important is that if you invest in the customer experience driven by some AI collaboration, then you're going to achieve returns in excess of 10 times your investment. So as a result of these, you know, new customer expectations and the increased focus and spend on AI that we see in the industry, we're seeing some very clear trends. The first is this use of AI, both in transaction efficiency and pricing. So we're seeing AI applications really sort of on the operational side of the insurance business, helping speed up the sales and the underwriting process, as well as fraud detection, you know, with some applications of voice recognition. The second big trend we're seeing is that, you know, the Internet of Things is maturing. We have lots of applications across property, casualty, and life where we, you know, we'll see devices or apps providing safe driving discounts by logging times when you're in the car and you're acting as a safe driver. We're now even seeing fitness monitors that can alert you when you should go ahead and see a doctor and so forth. And I think the, you know, those applications will continue to evolve in the next year or so. The third item that we see a lot of sort of AI application is extracting structured data from an image, right? So this concept of computer vision and taking that data from an image and using it to make decisions. So we're seeing this use case a lot in claims. So for example, when you unfortunately have a car accident, you know, sending in a photo of the car and then receiving immediate claims feedback based on that data that was extracted from the photograph. Now, I think a lot of this is still emerging, and we're going to see, you know, carriers will need to focus on more on less of the efficiency and more of how can I help this customer during a loss, right? How can I help this customer feel like we really care? And I think we'll see future use cases of where, you know, drones are sent out to accident sites to inspect the car, and, you know, Ubers and Lyfts will be dispatched so that a customer doesn't have to go ahead and call for a ride themselves and things of that nature. And the fourth trend, I think this is sort of emerging still, is that we're finally starting to see customer experience become a heavy focus. And I think that's because carriers realize that, you know, long-term sustainable differentiation will come from creating a personalized customer experience. So it's no longer enough to use artificial intelligence to primarily cut down on costs. Right? It's no longer enough to just be operationally efficient, but that we need to look at more use cases of where that AI can be used to enhance the experience. And that's right in line with what your customers are demanding today, right? What do they want? Well, as a result of, you know, the experiences they're having with other brands and the insurtechs that are offering things at their fingertips, insurers really are looking for cross-channel, personalized, rich experiences. They're looking for that experience to be seamless, consistent, connected. And I think a really great word to describe this is, you know, fracture-free and frictionless. Right? No customer wants to have to go through a lot of steps or inconvenience or feel like they're not being talked to as an individual. They also want interactions where they want them, when they want them, and how they want them. So providing them a plethora of options of channels to engage with you in is really where things need to head. And in doing that, providing them high value exchanges that really show them that you're going above and beyond and that you do care for them as an individual customer. So with customers demanding more, right, and those expectations are real and those expectations are here, you know, AI can be utilized to help you deliver those rich experiences. And if you think about, you know, what's the business case for investing in AI, right, it really only makes sense if it's solving a business problem that is focused on the customer. So in that, it needs to extend to the servicing of the insured, powering best-in-class communications with them. And why is that? Well, communications are the key to building relationships, and relationships are the key for your success, right? Creating loyalty amongst your customer base. And relationships aren't built in silence. So really, we need to focus on your communications and how you can overcome some of the challenges that most carriers face. What are some of those challenges? Well, the first is, you know, many carriers are not sending enough communication. There's just not enough happening between you and your insured. Creating a great customer experience relies heavily on communication. The second is, when there is communication, it's most likely for the wrong reasons. I have a really, you know, interesting story to tell you. You know, most of our staff are in New York City. So most of us, you know, rent our apartments, don't have necessarily, you know, a car of our own. And one of our staff members, you know, was insured by Geico for her renter's insurance. And every time she would receive a communication from Geico, it always talked about adding an auto policy. And it was very clear that Geico had no idea who this customer was. They're in New York City. they're renting their apartment, it's highly unlikely that they have an automobile. So not only did the policy communications come with that and the bills come with banners related to that, but then there were marketing pamphlets being sent in the mail that were specific to auto policies. And so not only was that a waste of time and money on the carrier's part, but it started to create a breakdown in the relationship with the customer because my colleague started to ignore all of the communications coming in from Geico. No longer did she open the mail from them. No longer did she look at any of those emails because she felt that there was truly a breakdown in trust. How can I trust this carrier who doesn't even know who I am? The third challenge we've heard about is, you know, we just don't have access to the data that we need to create, you know, rich, highly contextualized conversations and communications. And the reality is that's just not true. As a carrier, you have so much information and data that's at your fingertips, it may just not be as easily accessible, right? That's that concept of these disparate systems. So if we can create a sort of a connected silo where you can extract some of that data and use that data to power your communications, imagine the customer experience that you could deliver. So now that we've established that you have to think about the customer experience, you have to communicate better with your customers overall, let's discuss how artificial intelligence can help you create relationships with your customers by driving digital communications that deliver real valuable experiences. So we'll focus on some use cases that you can take away from this webinar and you can look to implement now. And this is a perfect time to bring Mia in because Mia is our in-house insurance communications expert. So let's go ahead and talk to Mia. Mia, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks, Liz.
So Mia, I know that, you know, you're constantly meeting with our insurance clients and having discussions with them related to the challenges that they face when it comes to communicating with our clients. What have you seen or what do you see is the biggest challenge for carriers in this regard?
The biggest challenge really for any insurance carrier is the relationship with the customer. Very often, they're not the ones that would have been at the coalface with a client in any way, be it via the website or via their own staff. A policy is usually bought via a broker or, you know, customers tend to go online and do research themselves. So that relationship is non-existent. And so when carriers do start communicating with those customers, it tends to also be very generic. It's not at all relevant to the end customer. And so there is no relationship. And that is such a huge challenge. And then when you look at the new insurtech companies coming in that are granted really focused on the small part of the market, but are training the end customer in terms of what to expect when it comes to service, they're digitally first. They understand what customers want, and that servicing in a digital manner that is quick, to the point, relevant. I mean, we've got examples where claims have been resolved in 3 seconds. It's a new world, and it's really challenging. And the only way to really overcome that digital challenge and build that relationship is with communication.
Mm-hmm. I mean, what really stood out to me, you said two R words, right? Relationship and relevant. And how can you build a relationship if your communications are not relevant to the customer?
So that's the point.
Yeah. So with this challenge, Mia, how do you think artificial intelligence could assist with that?
I think reinsurers carriers are really in a unique position because they've got all of this data at hand. They're like this huge data bank, have so much information on each customer. So being able to unlock that data using AI processes and machine learning to really deliver content that's relevant, that's where the gap is, and that's where they can really make inroads. And it, as I said before, it starts with communications. And the communications isn't just about marketing or your bill or your policy. It's about the entire customer journey. So we know many companies have been focusing on plotting out the touch points based on a customer journey. But we're now in a position where AI processes can allow for a customized and predictive customer journey. So as an example, if I make a claim because I've suffered a loss, those touch points are completely unique to me. My claim is unique, and they need to start the second I start making a claim. I should be getting communications that talk about my claim, what I can expect next. If you are servicing the customer, as you mentioned, where you're dispatching an Uber, follow that up with communication that actually matches everything that you're doing, so that that starts building a really trusted relationship. It's completely personal to me. That journey are touch points based on my own journey with their insurer, and it builds a relationship in a way that a generic customer lifecycle journey, as much as that really does build a relationship, once you start customizing it, it's completely different.
Yeah, I mean, I think we all have talked to the last couple of years about customer journey mapping and how important that is to an enterprise to do. But I love how you brought up, you know, this idea of a personalized customer journey and this predictive journey, because I think, yeah, that's exactly it. I mean, if you look at what's on the screen here, Salesforce came up with AI is going to grow so much in the next 2 years. And a lot of that has to do with these personalized journeys.
I think the point of all of this is to create, you know, to get rid of a lot of the friction that exists. And the friction and confusion for a customer comes from not knowing what to expect, what's included in the policy. If you're removing that and creating a frictionless experience, and you can achieve that with AI, that's the number one prize.
Absolutely, absolutely. So what are some use cases, Mia, that, you know, maybe you haven't seen them yet in the market, but you are having conversations about, that use artificial intelligence beyond what we're seeing now, you know, traditional sort of operational functions, and bringing them into the customer communications?
I think that we've, many of the use cases, we've seen them in marketing, we've seen them touched on in the insurance sphere. It hasn't really been explored in depth. We see it touched on in little bits, and I'll go into that as examples. But I think number one is, I've mentioned before, personalizing, like hyper-personalization. Being able to use the data on hand, be it demographic, geographic, and any other data, you know, what policy they have, you know, where they live, how old they are, what stage of their life they're in, and starting to hyper-personalize that communication, that adds value in ways to the customer that will actually give value back to the insurer in terms of increasing the products that the customer may buy. Once I'm getting information that's relevant and you're predicting my next step based on every other step I've taken, and you give me an offer that is given to me at the right time, at the right stage of my life, I'm more likely to take it up. So I'd say hyper-personalization and next best action or offer, which uses both machine learning and AI processes. The next item I would say to really focus on is voice. How do you integrate communications with voice technologies? And this is a way to sort of bridge the gap and make it seem like you have an omni-channel experience, even though you may not have broken down the silos and have a single view of the customer. Once you start integrating technologies that make the customer feel like there is coherence and integration in everything that they touch, it makes a difference. So we recently saw an insurance carrier in the US, Travelers, has a massive partnership with Alexa, with Amazon and Alexa, which is fantastic because they're integrating voice into what they do as an insurance carrier. But it's really only touching the surface. You can find out when your payment is due. You can request your auto insurance ID card to be mailed to you, and you can get your billing account number, or you can get your policy number. But what if you took it a step further? What if you can find out when your payment is due and make a payment? You know, once that, if, as an example, you're sending the customer a bill and you're integrating that communication with your voice technology, that's actually quite easy to do, where you can get them to pay via voice. So it's like taking it a step further to make that entire customer experience so much better. And the last thing to think about is integrating with chatbots. I mean, most carriers have got a chatbot servicing clients on a website or portal, and they can be dumb bots or intelligent bots. Difference being one is just pulling answers from a database, and the other one, it is understanding the natural language of the customer and providing answers that sound far more intelligent. I mean, Lemonade, one of the insurtechs in the US, has had tweets about its chatbot being friendlier than most other call centers that you call. So what if you took that intelligence and you started integrating it into your email communications, as an example? You send out an email that the policy is due for renewal, or there's a claim that's under review, and you have a click-to-chat button along with a call to call center. You're giving the customer the option to then chat with you in the manner in which they prefer. And I'm the sort of person who would avoid the phone at all costs. So if you gave me an easy way that straight from an email and click to chat, and you know everything there is to know about my query because you know that that email was sent, you know who I am, and you know what the query is about, and that conversation's already started, it takes that friction away and it improves that customer experience.
Yeah. Wow, Mia. I mean, I love this concept of integrating your current communication with a bot. And I want to come back to that in a second, but I made some notes while you were talking. I think when you were speaking about hyper-personalization, wow, I see for a carrier, they're able to use those communications to actually move the customer from one sort of stage in the buying process to another, making that customer much more valuable customer to them. I see that as a huge benefit. And then I loved how you talked about integrating with voice because it's so convenient. I mean, how many of us aren't using our voice assistants? Where all of us use them in some, you know, fashion today. So how great would it be to be able to pay, you know, my insurance bill? But let's focus on this bot conversation because I think you're right on the money here. I mean, last year at InsurTech Connect, we saw the Lemonade CEO talk about this, that insurance leaders, you know, are going to be using bots, not brokers, and AI, not actuaries. And I think that's not as far off from today, because as you mentioned, there's really easy ways for us to integrate bots into communications.
For sure, and it really does give that view of a seamless communication when I'm able to do things because I received an email and it's integrated to voice, or I can immediately click out of my email to another channel, and it all seems integrated. That experience is gold.
Definitely. And it goes back to giving customers what they want, right? Which is delivering communications in the channel of their choosing. So fantastic idea there. Now, where do you see machine learning coming into play here? Because I think we always sort of toss out these terms, you know, AI, machine learning. Where do you really see that fitting in with customer communications?
I think very quickly to clarify, machine learning and AI seem to be used interchangeably, but they are very different. Machine learning is deciding which content, when it comes to communication, deciding which content is best suited to a customer based on the data you have at hand. So you have this data, you have this customer, and you're marrying the two, and you're using machine learning in which to do that. AI is really about the predictive nature around that, and it's intelligence above the machine learning, and using those both together creates a really powerful tool and customer experience. So where machine learning is putting the right content for the customer and you're able to hyper personalize that communication, AI is able to predict the customer's behavior, and you can really put the next best offer or action within that communication to increase the value each customer has with you.
So it really is a fair statement to say that machine learning can transform your communications.
Absolutely. It takes them from generic to customized to hyper-personalized, and it's building up that relationship and trust.
Fantastic. And we know insurance companies are really great at stats and algorithms, right? And data. So why not play on that strength and use that data to transform your communications?
Definitely. Use the strengths at hand.
So with that, how does the carrier really benefit by implementing AI into their communications?
I think that there are so many benefits from the carrier's perspective. I'm going to focus on two. One being the trusted relationship that will come out of it and increasing customer value. You know, from a trusted relationship perspective, it's really built through communication. And communication that is generic just contributes to a frustrating relationship or a breakdown. Like the Geico example you brought up earlier, these endless auto insurance pamphlets, they, considering most clients have no need or requirement to visit the insurer's portal unless they need to submit a claim, creating the trust is of paramount importance. And achieving it can only really be done with data and using technology well. And so when you marry data with machine learning and AI, you're taking your communications to another level. And then the customer lifetime value, as I mentioned, you know, being able to grow the customer's value beyond an initial policy, it's never going to be achieved through a knock and drop approach. It's going to be achieved through a trusted and a personalized relationship. And that's going to come from a customized and personalized communication in a way that really makes sense to the customer. And of course, there's so many other benefits. You know, you're providing a better customer experience. You can provide these predictive customized journeys. There's a cohesive customer experience rather than a fractured one. So there are so many benefits, but the two that make the world of difference, the relationship and increasing the customer lifetime value.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. And so what would you think on, you know, the insured side, the customer side, what are the benefits, you know, they're reaping? Because as a customer, one doesn't think about, you know, customer lifetime value. So what's important to them and what will they receive?
I certainly don't want to be thinking about lifetime value. I don't want to be thinking about paying my insurer more. I think that's where the problem with the relationship between insured and carrier comes in the first place. Like for the most part, most people pay into an insurance provider month on month with nothing in return unless they suffer a loss. And so from a servicing perspective and a feeling of trust and knowing this company that we're paying money to consistently is a valuable relationship, that makes a difference rather than one that we don't trust at all and we don't like having to pay this money. And then from a claims and servicing perspective, if my claims are so much easier or I can service myself because of the communications I receive and using voice, that makes a huge difference to me as a customer.
Definitely. I mean, I think every single one of us on this webinar, we are a customer, right? We all have insurance policies. So thinking about what is it that we would really want to see from our carrier. Fantastic. Well, thank you, Mia, for such a wonderful discussion. I think you outlined some great use cases, some clear benefits for both carriers and most importantly, you know, their customers. So I think it would help us all to sort of summarize that one more time. If we look at the benefits for the carrier, it's really about the relationship, as Mia brought up. Without a relationship, you know, there really is nothing more. So utilizing AI in your customer communications will help you build that trust with them. And that will allow you to create predictive journeys, right? And predictive journeys will help you as an enterprise assess the true health of the relationship that you have with your customers and provide you the ability to tailor your communications to that customer. And that will provide an enhanced customer experience overall, right? So I think that's the goal everyone has is in anything we do is let's make the experience better. But focusing on your communications, you can truly drive that to a measurable extent, right, by increasing the customer lifetime value. And I think at, you know, all carriers on this webinar today would agree that, you know, CLV has become a KPI of great interest to most executive committees. So, you know, anything we can do to increase that will definitely help drive value back into the business. And then I think, you know, what you mentioned about that cohesion and providing a fracture-free, a frictionless experience to the customer is highly valuable, because that's where that breakdown in trust comes in, when customers start to experience friction. And so removing that is key. And then, you know, I know you touched on this a little bit, but I don't think we can stress it enough. Just making yourself increasingly more competitive within a market where it is easier for customers to change carriers. Gone are the days where we sort of stuck with one carrier forever. Now we go and compare, because with a few key strokes of our fingertips, we can do that. So applying AI in your customer communications will prevent that from happening, because it will benefit the relationship and drive loyalty. So as far as benefits for the insured, you know, those personalized customer journeys, Mia, as you discussed, really developing and instilling in the customer that, hey, my carrier knows who I am, and my carrier understands how I'm feeling about this particular process, or my carrier really understands what sort of product I would need next, instead of just marketing to me, you know, sort of blanketly. And that will create these hyper-personalized communications along with these real-time offers, you know, this concept that Mia talked about, using that data to drive the next best message to the customer that will allow them to take the next best action. And then, you know, intelligent chatbots. I mean, I know my preference is to chat. I don't want to have to talk to someone if I don't want to, and I don't want to necessarily wait for an email response. I sort of want instant gratification. So knowing that, you know, my email can launch an intelligent chatbot conversation where I can get the information I need is highly convenient. And then integrating with that voice technology, where that convenience just becomes even more abundant by being able to say, hey, Google, you know, pay my insurance bill. So never having to log into a website, put in a username and password, but just being able to action that off of the email that I got with my bill. So to sum it all up, implementing artificial intelligence in your customer communications, as Mia brought up, can have a massive impact now. So we know that AI is useful for predicting user behavior, but because you as a carrier have so much data on hand, you know, like past behavior, demographics, location, you can use that with an AI tool to provide content based on that predictive journey to hyper-personalize your communications so that they're relevant to that individual consumer. It will also allow you to deliver messaging that prompts the user's next action, whether that's sales or operational in nature. Also looking at AI, you know, you can harness the power of integrating these intelligent chatbots into your communication. And think about it from a multitude of perspectives, right? Launching the bot off from a marketing email. So now this AI-powered bot can move me from one stage in the buying process to the next. Or a claims email, right? Click to chat using this proper bot that knows who I am and knows how to move me forward in the claims process in such a way where I can feel the empathy, you know, from the enterprise. And there's that integration of communications with your voice assistant. So we talked about how highly convenient it would be to take these applications a step further, right? So right now they're being used to provide policy details, but how great would it be to add an insured, or to add a new rider to my policy, or to pay my bill, to service in ways where I don't need to go to the portal and or I don't need to go and call the customer service center. These are all things you can do now because these are communications that you're sending out now, but they can be powered and improved on by using AI technology. So now you might ask, okay, well, we know what we should do and why we should do it, but how, right? How, where do I even begin? Well, just like any sort of digital transformation initiative, it is a process. So think of this as a path, right? This is a path that doesn't need to take years. It doesn't need to take massive changes in your technology, but instead leverage what you have, right? By creating these connected silos. And to start, you'll map your digital communications process. So what are you currently sending out today to your customers across all lines of business? And where are the sources of data coming from for those communications? The next is to look at, you know, where could you apply AI processes and systems to enhance those current digital communications initiatives? And then we need to look at the data, right? So let's look at all the data that you have on hand, and maybe there's some data that you don't have, but we don't need to wait for that, right? We use the data you have while working towards the data that you want. This next step, I think, is probably one of the most important steps. And this is, again, going back to that connected silo. We need to look at aligning departmental agendas, right? It's the only way we're going to deliver fracture-free and frictionless digital customer experiences. So taking a look enterprise-wide, how do we get marketing communications and operational communications and claims communications? How can we get them to look and feel the same, have the same tone? What tools can we use to drive data so that those become much more contextualized and hyper-personalized? And then we can deliver those hyper-personalized messages, right? So once we've identified, you know, where that data is coming from, what tools to use, and how we can sort of connect the different lines of business, we can start to develop those. And then we can augment those communications with chatbots and voice assistants. So that brings our, you know, discussion to an end today. Now, at this point, we would love to hear from you. So please post your questions in the chat if you haven't already done so, and we'll make sure to answer them. So we'll go ahead and take a look at our first question that has come in. And that question is, what would be the easiest place to start implementing or testing artificial intelligence in my customer communication process? Mia, do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Sure. I would say the easiest place to begin would be the biggest pain point, because the minute you're solving a pain point, you're bringing a solution to the table. So, you know, look at the most frequent touch points you have with customers, be it the policy renewals or even marketing. Like, how can you improve those? It's usually around the transactional type of communications. Those are the touch points that insurers tend to have with their customers. So policy renewal, a bill, what does that look like? How can you improve that? And then start the communication journey from there.
Mm-hmm. I like how you speak about it as sort of bite-sized chunks. I think that's what we always talk to our clients about, is look at this in a manageable way.
For sure. If you look at the entire gambit of communications, it's going to take years before you make any inroads. So start one at a time.
Fantastic. So we have another question posted here. It reads, you spoke about going from email to an intelligent chatbot to pay a bill or a premium. What other use cases have you seen using the same scenario, going from email to bot? So I'll take a stab at this one, and then Mia, please feel free to, you know, to comment on what you've seen with some of our clients as well. But, you know, if you think about an intelligent bot, it can be used for any sort of servicing, you know, anything the customer needs. It could be as simple as providing those policy details, as we saw in the traveler's example. but you could extend that functionality to include the ability for a customer who just purchased some expensive valuables to add a rider onto their, you know, existing homeowner's policy. The key here is, you know, if a customer wants to chat or use voice without having to pick up the phone and dial, we should be allowing them to. And so we should give customers what they want in the channel of their choosing. And that's not limited to the web, right? So any communication that you're delivering to the customer should then be able to extend out to these other channels that the customer would prefer to interact with you in. I don't know, Mia, if you have any additional thoughts.
I mean, not insurers, carriers don't really suffer from a collections process like other industries do. But we've seen chatbots work really well in collections because customers don't necessarily want to speak to someone. Yeah, it's easier to chat. So look at the communications where it's easier to chat. And it, reducing that call center volume has a huge impact on costs too. So the operational efficiency advantages are also greatly beneficial to the carrier.
Definitely. So we have a third question here that talks about the Internet of Things. It says, you mentioned the Internet of Things and how this is impacting insurance. Can you elaborate a little? So sure, I'll talk a little bit about what we're seeing. You know, using data from millions of devices connected to the Internet, carriers are able to sort of record these events leading up to and during an incident, right? So they have a lot of data on you know, sort of what they see leading up to that actual loss. And so when you file a car accident claim, carriers, you know, will already have a lot of that required information based on the data from your car, cameras in the vicinity, even your Apple Watch, even, you know, your phone. So this makes the claims process much more efficient. And I think from the carrier's perspective, even more importantly, right, it really reduces fraud. But I think what's even more exciting is the ability to predict and prevent an accident. I think that's where the Internet of Things is really evolving and maturing. You know, and an example of that is your car monitors speed and braking when you drive. And this information goes back to the carrier along with a myriad of data from other relevant sources. And through that data, the carrier can now recognize sort of erratic driving or bad weather conditions and can issue a warning, right, to you as the driver, to the customer, to slow down or to get off the roads and to possibly prevent an accident from happening. And I think we'll continue to see that evolve, right? That hasn't been completely fleshed out, but, you know, this is how, you know, sort of autonomous driving, right? All of this data is going to be used to evolve the experience that we currently have and hopefully prevent a lot of, the future losses out there.
Liz, if I could bring this back to communication, mm-hmm. Imagine if at the end of the month, your insurer is sending you a summary of the driving report as they see it and your good standing with them. A little bit like Nest does with their emails, where it gives you a summary of your usage. That starts adding value to you from your insurer. So I see the Internet of Things and how it can impact your claims process, but it can definitely also help in the communications and building that.
Definitely. I'm so glad you brought up that Nest example because I love those communications they send out because it actually motivates and changes my behavior. And that's exactly it. Those communications that are powered by the data from the Internet of Things, that can change behavior on the customer side. And I think, you know, carriers, you want to prevent, you know, additional losses. So if you can change, you know, at least one driver's behavior, you know, why wouldn't you? Okay, so I think those are all the questions we've received thus far, but please, if you have additional questions, please feel free to reach out to Mia or myself. We'll make sure to answer them. You know, we here at Striata, we help our clients and our prospective clients map out their digital communications process. So that path that we talked about to using AI in your communications, we can help you with that. So please feel free to reach out to us to discuss that. And thanks once again for attending today's webinar, How AI-Powered Communications Will Enhance the Customer Experience in Insurance. And we hope to see you all again very soon. Have a great day.